So in the last class or in the last few classes we have studied three vrittis, Rudanta vritti, Samasa vritti, Tadvita. And we are focusing on Samasa. Samasa means combining, compounding. And regarding Samasa, certain rules we saw that the words which are combined, they lose their case suffix generally. And then Vigraha Vakyam, Vrutti. Vrutti idea also we saw that Vigraha. Explanatory note, cut vritti, it is called vigraha, what is called? Arthabodhakam vakyam, is vigraha. So vigraha means explanatory note, we saw that. And then we also saw two types of samasa, nitya samasa, anitya samasa. And then we started seeing the types of samasa. There are four types of samasa and sometimes one more is added and therefore it becomes five types of samasa. And this division is made based on which word is important. And also the names are given, names are used based on the Adhikara in the Paniniya Ashtadhyayi. Paniniya, in Paniniya Ashtadhyayi, they have discussed each samasa in a particular portion. The first samasa is Avyayi Bhava Samasa, which is introduced in 215. Prat Tat Purusha, Avyayi Bhavaha, the sutra is Avyayi Bhavaha. And its Adhikara will go up to 2120. 215 to 2120, the Adhikara will. Adhikara, have you been taught what is Adhikara? Jurisdiction, the effectiveness, the area, that is called Adhikara. And then afterwards Tatpurusha Samasa is introduced, which also will have Adhikara 2, 1, 21 to 2, 2, 22. Up to that Adhikara is there, Tatpurusha. Idea is that under those sutras, this particular sutra, a particular Samasa is taught. So from 215 to 2120, Avyayi Bhava Samasa is talked about. Then Tatpurusha Samasa is talked about from 2121 to 2222. Then Bahuvrihi Samasa. I think these words we have written.
Yes.
So Bahuvrihi Samasa from 2223, 2.2, 2223 to 2228. Is Bahuvrihi Samasa. And then last one is Dvandva Samasa. Dvandva Samasa. That is in 2229 it is given. Alright. These are just technical details, nothing much to do with our understanding of samasa. What we are understanding for that, these details are not very important, but those who are studying the sutras and already they have gone ahead, for them it may be useful. Alright. We have seen the first type of samasa is called avyayi bhavah bhava samasa. Which is purva padartha pradhana. Purva padartha pradhana means the samasa where the meaning of the first word, first component is important. Pradhana, important. Padartha, the meaning of the word. Purva means the first. Avyayi bhava is the samasa where the meaning of the first word is important. I have given the example, Upakrishnam. Upakrishnam means near Krishna. If we do the vigraha of this, will be Krishnasya. Near Krishna, proximate to Krishna. Here, Upa is the first word, Krishna is the second word. And the meaning of the first word Upa is Pradhanam, is important. And the important means what? How do we know Upa is important? Importance is decided by knowing that which word of the compound is connected with the verb. Along with this samasa, you will be using some verb. That verb is connected with which part of the compound, that part is considered to be important. So the part of the samasa which is connected with the verb will decide whether it is pradhanam or not. The part which is connected with the verb, that is considered pradhanam, important. Like we say, Upakrishnam tishtati Arjuna. I think last time also I gave this example. Arjuna stands near Krishna. So, this tishtati is directly connected to with what? Near. Upa. Therefore, Upa is considered to be this pradhan. The meaning of the word Upa is connected with the meaning of the word tishtati, therefore this upa will be considered to be pradhana padam. The meaning of the word upa will be called pradhana padartha. Padartha means the meaning of the word. So here in this samasa, purva padartha, upa, the purva padartha is the meaning of the word upa, which is samipa, he is important. Why is important, is considered to be important? So that will be connected directly with the verb. Arjuna stands near Krishna. Tishthati is connected to Krishna, but not directly. Directly connected to what? Upa. Near. In English also we say, Arjuna stands near Krishna. So, stands directly connected to near. And therefore, Upa will be called, considered Pradhan. Any word or word meaning connected to the verb is considered to be Pradhanam, important. Upa Krishnam. Alright. Another example I had given. I want to clarify something about that, therefore I am repeating. Yatha Shakti Dehi. Dehi means please give. Please give as per. Yatha means as per. Shakti, capacity. So, Dehi is directly connected with what? As per. In keeping with. Therefore, Yatha is the Pradhanam. And it is a Purva Padartha. Therefore, this Samasa is Avyayi Bhava Samasa. Here, we had seen one point. That in Avyayi Bhava Samasa, all the Samasa will be Avyaya. When I said generally, and I first I give Upa Krishnam, then I said no, Yatha Shakti I will give the example. But let me clarify, I would like to correct that. Upa Krishnam also has got Avyaya Sangha only. Upa Krishnam is Avyaya Sangha only. Only thing, when you study further grammar, you will know Avyaya Apsupaha, that is one sutra, which says that after Avyaya, whatever supratyaya comes is dropped. That's the rule. After avyaya, like cha. After cha also supratyaya will come. Samanya supratyaya su will come. But there is a sutra in Panini Ashtadhyayi. Avyaya apsupaha luksya. Means there will be elision of supratyaya after avyaya. So chakara also is a subanta only. Even though it looks like that it is not. But technically it is subanta. Only thing, it lopa has taken place. Like today we studied Upanishad. Upanishad is a which vritti?
Kridantam.
Now just now we studied? Kridantam. Now where is kritpratyaya in that?
Where?
It has come and gone. Okay? Still it is, Upanishad is Kridanta or not?
Yes.
That's what. So it is Kridanta only. So see, some example came, but I cannot be good. So, cha, after cha also supratyaya comes. And supratyaya is elided by the sutra Avyayat Apsupaha. And similarly here, Yatha Shakti, after that, Yatha Shakti, he has got Avyaya Sanna, because Avyayi Bhava Samasa. So, Avyayi Bhava Sya, there is a sutra by that, the Avyayi Bhava Samasa will have Avyaya Sanna. So, it will become in decline. After in decline, Supratya will come, after Yatha Shakti. Su will come. But it will be aligned. Okay? So Yatha Shakti also is Subanta, but Su is gone. Is it clear? So all Avyayi Bhava Samasa are Avyaya, without any exception. Alright. But then Swami, how come here Upa Krishnam it became? Here, Upa Krishna word was formed. Krishnasya Samipam. Krishna, Upa, then it becomes Upa Krishna. There are so many rules for that. Krishna, Krishna, Das. Then Upakrishna. So Upakrishna is Avyaya only. And since it is Avyaya, the Lopa of the Sup should happen. Suha will come. And its Lopa was to happen. Then there is another sutra which says, in case of Akaranta Avyayi Bhava Samasa, Akaranta Avyayi means ending with A. Upakrishna is ending with what? A. So for those Samasa, Am Adesha will happen. So instead of elision, this Sup will have Am Adesha. And therefore, Luk will not happen, elision will not happen, and Am will come. Therefore, Upakrishna. But Upakrishnam is indeclinable only. Even though you are seeing like Vanam, Vane, etc., Vanam, Upakrishnam, but Avyaya. Only thing, after getting Avyaya Sangha, the status of being indeclinable, further operation of elision was to happen, that did not happen. Instead of that, this Am Adesha has come. But Upakrishnam also is Avyaya, Yathashakti also is Avyaya. Okay? So, Avyayi Bhava Samasa, all the words, all the compounded words will be Avyaya, indeclinable. Alright. So, here, Yathashakti, Upakrishnam, etc. Some more example I can give, but one or two and then we proceed. Pratidinam, every day, that also is what? Avyayi Bhava Samasa. Detail we will study later on. Pratidinam. Yatha Kramam. Pratidinam means every day, and Yatha Kramam means as per order, in order. Yatha Kramam Agacha means what?
Come in order.
Come in order. Yatha Kramam, as per order, in keeping with the order of your sitting, alphabet, whatever. Yatha Kramam, Pratidinam means every day. Yatha Kramam means as per order. Order here means not instruction, okay? Order means succession. One after the other. So these are Avyayi Bhava Samasa. Afterwards we'll study, we'll see whether we would like to study further in detail. But briefly speaking, Avyayi Bhava Samasa is the samasa where the first word is Pradhanam, because that is what is connected with the verb. Now we'll go to the next samasa. Very widely used samasa with so many varieties. Tat Purusha Samasa. The example is Vedanta. And what is the definition of Tat Purusha Samasa? Uttara Padartha Pradhanaha Tatpurushaha. Uttara Padartha Pradhanaha Tat Purusha Samasa. means tatpurusha samasa is that in which uttara padartha, the second, the meaning of the second word or the later word is pradhanam, a compound in which the meaning of the second word is important. That samasa, that compound is called tatpurusha samasa. All right. Example is of Vedanta. What is the vigraha of Vedanta? Vedasya or Veda? Both. Vedasya. So here, anta means the end, Vedasya of Vedasya. Now we write Vedanta word, and along with Vedanta, if you use some verb, like I say, what is written here? Vedantam patha. Okay, my tongue may be difficult for you to read. Are you able to read? Huh? What is the sentence? Vedanta patha. Patha means what? I read Vedanta. Now, the connection is with Veda or connection is with Anta?
Anta.
Because we are not studying the whole Vedas. We are studying what? Anta. So, the verb Pathami has got connection with what? Anta. Anta is a Purva Padartha or Purva Pada or Uttara Pada? So, the Pathami is connected with Anta. And Anta is what? Uttara Pada. And Uttara Padartha is important. Why is it important?
Because it's connected with the word.
Which verb?
The second word is connected with the word. That's
which verb?
Patam.
So, antam is the uttara pada. Its meaning, the end, is connected with pathami. Therefore, this Uttara Padartha, the meaning of the word Anta, is important. Important, what is the Sanskrit word?
Pradhana.
And the samasa where Uttara Padartha is Pradhana is called what?
Tatpurusha.
Is it clear? The compound in which the meaning of the later part is important. That samasa is? I am telling so many times. Okay? I expect that next time that I ask you, you will be able to respond. Now it may sound so many times, but Swamiji would have repeated once more. Okay. Uttara Padartha Pradhana. Alright. I will give one more some examples. It will be clear. Means what? Okay. In this blue lotus, what is more prada? What is important?
Blue.
What is more important? Lotus. Lotus or willow? Lotus is important. Why lotus is more important, because if I write Vikasati, you have studied, no? Vikasati, which where it takes?
Blooms.
Where did it come? So, infant reader, first, I think few lessons it has come. Third or fourth lesson it comes. Pushpani, Vikasanti. So, Nilo, Palam. So, what is blooming? Blue is blooming or old lotus is blooming? So, Vikasati has got connection with Utpala. And therefore, Utpalam is Pradhanam, important. Is it clear? Utpalam is Pradhanam, right? That has got connected with the word. Therefore, Utpala is Pradhanam, and Utpalam is Uttarapada. Uttarapadartha is Pradhanam. The meaning of the later word is Pradhanam, because that is connected with the meaning denoted by the verb. Therefore, Uttara Padartha Pradhanam is the Uttara. Alright, one more. सूर्य गच्छति पुत्र आगच्छति कस्य पुत्र आगच्छति सो पुत्र इज पुत्र इज कनेक्टेड विद गच्छति नॉट सूर्य द सन इज नॉट गोइंग सूर्य पुत्र आगच्छति तो सूर्यस्य पुत्रः सो हियर The sun is not going. The sun of the sun is going. S-O-N of the S-U-N is going. And therefore, S-O-N is important. Okay? Putraha is important. And Putra is the Purva or Uttara? Therefore, the Samasa is what? Clear? Now, let me go to the word Tatpurusha itself. What is the meaning of avyayi bhava samasa I have given? Avyayi bhava.
Anavyayam avyayi karoti. Bhavati.
Anavyayam avyayi bhavati. Anavyayam avyayi sampadyate.
Avyayam sampadyate. Avyayam bhavati. Anavyayam avyayam bhavati iti avyayi bhava. Bhavati, not karoti. So, Avyayi bhava samasa is that where the final compound form is indeclinable. Therefore, it is called Avyayi bhava samasa. The samasa characterized by the state of being indeclinable. This is the meaning of Avyayi bhava samasa. Clear? What is the meaning of Avyayi bhava samasa?
The samasa whose form is indeclinable.
Last one. Who is indeclinable?
Who is
not
form is indeclinable?
The samasa?
Samasa
whose
form is indeclinable.
Okay. Little bit, last sentence I explained.
samasa characterized by the form which is indeclinable.
The samasa characterized by the status of being indeclinable. Okay, that is exact definition. But what you said, idea wise, correct. So now tatpurusha samasa. What is the meaning of tatpurusha? Tatpurusha doesn't have the meaning which conveys any nature of samasa. Tatpurusha samasa is an example of tatpurusha. Tatpurusha word is an example of tatpurusha samasa. Okay, let us see what is tatpurusha. Of tatpurusha samasa is the samasa presented in Panini Ashtadhyayi from 2121 to 2222. That is tatpurusha. Okay, that is technical definition. Tatpurusha samasa is that samasa which is described in Paniniya in that particular portion 2121. 2222. That is tatpurusha samasa. That is a sangha given by Panini. There is a sutra, tatpurusha. That is the sutra, that's Pachin sutra. Alright. But that will be too technical. Let us understand what is the simple meaning of tatpurusha samasa. Tatpurusha samasa is that samasa which is illustrated by, for which the example is given by the word tatpurusha. Tatpurusha samasa is the samasa for which the example given is the word tatpurusha. Tatpurusha is a tatpurusha samasa. Avyayi bhava is not avyayi bhava samasa. Okay, don't mention that. Avyayi bhava samasa is not avyayi bhava samasa. Avyayi bhava will be is a upapada samasa, different samasa. But tatpurusha samasa is a good example of tatpurusha. Okay, what is the meaning? Tasya purushaha. Tasya purushaha. Tatpurusha. Tatpurusha means purusha means a person. A person who is connected to that person. Devadatta. You can say Devadattaha Tatpurusha. Devadatta is Tatpurusha. Means what? Devadatta is his person. Like we know, he is his person. Devadatta is his person. So Tasya Purushaha is Tatpurusha. A person, Purusha, a person connected to that. Connected to him, that is called tatpurusha. And this tasya, we can say Ishvarasya. As we have studied, unless otherwise specified, tat word tat refers to whom?
Ishvara.
That is why Ishvara is called what? Pratama purusha. Why is it called Pratama Purusha? How is first person? He was there even before creation. So that is the problem of sitting here. You know? Okay. So, Tasya Purushasya. But it cannot be, it need not be Ishvarasya. It can be Rupasya. He is a person of the king. Tat Purushaha. So tasya rupasya purusha. So a person Devadatta is called tatpurusha because he is related to that person, related to him who has already been referred. So tatpurusha is the example of tatpurusha. How? Because when we see the vigraha tasya purushaha tatpurushaha, then the tatpurusha word we use, which word will be pradhan, which word will be pradhan?
Purusha.
Purusha. Why, how do we say purusha is pradhan? Can you give me the example? Tatpurusha vadati. Now, purusha vadati or tat vadati? Suppose tat refers to raja. Tasya nrupasya purushaha tatpurusha. Devadatta, suppose Devadatta. Devadatta is a tatpurusha. Can we call or not? Now, tatpurusha vadati. So, purusha, Devadatta is speaking or the nrupa is speaking? So purusha, the person who is connected to tat, him, rupa, that purusha is speaking, not raja will be somewhere else. Therefore the purusha is connected with the verb, therefore purusha is predominant, and if purusha is a uttarapada, therefore uttarapadartha pradhana, therefore it is tat purusha. Clear? The word purusha is connected with the verb, therefore purusha is the pradhanam, and pradhana word purusha is the uttarapada, therefore the samasa is uttarapadartha pradhana. Is it clear? Tatpurusha samasa has got so many varieties. We will see varieties later. Okay, let me go to the third variety. We are seeing now main varieties. After, if your interest and time is there, you will see in detail. I can teach samasa for 1 year, but that will not do. I will complete. I wanted to just give an idea enough so that when I talk about samasa, your face will bloom a little bit. That's right. So, next one is. So for seeing blooming, how much I have to work? Just seeing a blooming face, you know, so much I have to work. But I hope my work will pay off. Otherwise, after teaching also no blooming. I hope that will not happen. Bahugrihi samasa. It is what is written here?
Anya padartha.
Anya padartha.
Anya
padartha.
Pradhana. Anya padartha pradhana. I will give the example so it will be clear. This is a standard example. We give this. Pitambara. Pitambara means a person who is having pita, yellow, ambara dress. So, Pitambara is a yellow-dressed person. Okay? A yellow-dressed person. So, here, the final meaning is, in the meaning of samasa, Pitam also is not important, Ambara also is not important. Because what is finally referred to is Vishnu or Krishna. Pitam means yellow. Angara means dress. And in this, neither Pitam is important nor Angaram is important. When we say Pitambaraha Vishnu Gacchati. Now what is the verb here?
Gacchati.
Gacchati means what?
Goes.
Going. Goes. Now yellow is going? Going?
No.
Dress is going?
No.
Dress itself is not going, right? Dress is running. Neither yellow is going nor dress is going. Who is going? The person. So, it is neither Purva Padartha Pradhanam nor Uttara Padartha Pradhanam. Anya Padartha. Anya means some other. So, the meaning of some another word is predominant. The meaning of another word is prominent. Here, Pitam is also not important. Ambara also is not important. Pitambara, some meaning of some another word, Vishnu, is important. Such samasa is called Bahubrihi Samasa. Samasa is a compound in which the meaning of some another word. Another word means what? The word other than the constituents of the compound is important. Anya Padartha Pradhan. The meaning of another word, the word other than the constituents of the compound is important. Such samasa is called Bahubrihi Samasa. Alright.
Adjective.
That's what the samasa also is called adjectival compound. The English name for I did not give English name. So generally I don't remember English name. This bound is called attributive samasa, not adjective. Attributive samasa. Tatpurusha is called determinative samasa. Okay? I forgot that. And the Abhyayibhava already I given. Adverbial. I given one last time. So Abhyayibhava adverbial, Tatpurusha determinative. Bahubrihi is called attributive. Why it is called attributive? Because this samasa will be an attribute to some other person. Pitambara is an attribute. To Vishnu. So, when a compound is an attribute to some other person, then that samasa is called attributive compound. Bahubrihi Samasa. Just Bahubrihi Samasa itself is an example of Bahubrihi. Okay, that is why it's called Bahubrihi Samasa. Bahavaha Rihayaha Yasya Saha. Bahu means a lot. Vrihi means rice. A person who has got lot of rice, he is called Bahu Vrihi. Okay? Bahavaha, many, so much. Vrihayaha, rice. Yasya, who has. A person who has got lot of rice, paddy, he is called Bahu Vrihi. Is it clear? So Bahubrihi is an example of Bahubrihi, like Tatpurusha. Okay? That's what it is called Bahubrihi. Okay, more we'll see in the next class. Please read before coming to the class.